What is up, YouTube? It is Baseball Nerd back with another MLB video. Today's video that I have for you guys is my top 50 MLB players currently in the show, top 50 baseball players. And as you guys know from my other rankings, I compile this on a foundation of stats, looking at the stats that I find most valuable and getting my basis off of that, and then looking at, you know, predictions and projecting how people will trend this year, either upward or downward, off of age, injury, anything like that. And then the overall package of the player, not just hitting stats for position players, not just ERA or anything like that for pitchers. And so, yeah, it's my opinion, my discrepancy, so there will be difference of opinion between me and some of you guys. And if you disagree, man, let me know down below. I won't take it personal. Let me know who you think should be on the list, out of my list, who I should move up, who I should move down, who I'm crazy for putting in a certain spot. I'm totally cool with it. Let me know what you guys think below. We can talk about it. I appreciate it. Let's get right into the list. Starting at number 50, we have first baseman from the Chicago Cubs, Anthony Rizzo. Moving on to number 49, we got starting pitcher for the Washington Nationals, Steven Strasburg. At 48, I put in Michael Conforto, outfielder for the New York Mets. 47, we got our first catcher with Yasmani Grandal of the Chicago White Sox. 46, starting pitcher Aaron Nola for the Philadelphia Phillies. 45, we got Javi Baez of the Chicago Cubs, their shortstop. And then we got another shortstop back-to-back here. 44, Carlos Correa of the Houston Astros. At 43, I got the first base slash second baseman of the Dodgers, Max Muncy. 42, we got the center fielder slash second slash short, Ketel Marte of the Diamondbacks. 41, we got Jeff McNeil, second baseman, third baseman, or outfielder for the New York Mets, probably at second this year. At 40, we have Michael Brantley returning back to Houston, playing in the outfield for them. 39, my man Luke Voit, first baseman of the New York Yankees. 38, I put in Justin Turner, third baseman for the Los Angeles Dodgers, going back there. 37, Matt Olson, first baseman of the Oakland Athletics. 36, we got the man JD, Josh Donaldson, third baseman for the Minnesota Twins. 35, Marcell Ozuna, the outfielder for the Atlanta Braves. Next, we got 34, JT Realmuto, the best catcher in baseball for the Philadelphia Phillies. 33, people might think he's a little too low. I think this is a perfect spot for him, obviously. Xander Bogaerts, shortstop of the Boston Red Sox. 32, another, you know, controversial one. I have Trevor Bauer, starting pitcher for the Los Angeles Dodgers. And at 31, we got starting pitcher for the San Diego Padres, newly acquired from the Cubs, Yu Darvish. Getting into the top 30, we have AL MVP of last year, Jose Abreu, the first baseman for the Chicago White Sox. 29, we got shortstop of the Washington Nationals, Trey Turner. 28, the best defensive third baseman in the game, arguably Matt Chapman. 27, we got George Springer, center fielder for the Toronto Blue Jays, their newly acquired center fielder. 26, we have Max Scherzer, starting pitcher for the Washington Nationals. 25, we got Jose Ramirez, switch hitting third baseman for the Cleveland Indians, over there by himself now, no more Frankie Lindor. At 24, we have Corey Seager, not to be confused with Kyle Seager, shortstop for the Los Angeles Dodgers. Next, we have another Dodger at 23, Walker Buehler, starting pitcher for them. At 22, we have outfielder for the Philadelphia Phillies, Bryce Harper. I think he's going to have a really good year this year. Right above him, we have the outfielder for the New York Yankees, Aaron Judge, coming in at 21. At 20, we have first baseman for the St. Louis Cardinals, Paul Goldschmidt. I think some people were definitely undervaluing him this year. I think he'll be a stud. And at 19, we have DJ LeMahieu going back to the Yankees. I might be a little lower on DJ than some other people. I think he's a very, very good hitter. Hits a lot of balls in play, high contact rate, low strikeout rate. But I just have some of these guys above him because I think they bring more to a team. Number 18, we got third baseman for the San Diego Padres, Manny Machado. 17, starting pitcher for the Cleveland Indians, Shane Bieber. I know he was so unhittable last year. Just think it was a short season. I want to see him play a little bit more before I put him in the top 15. 16, we got Alex Bregman, third baseman of the Houston Astros. I know he had some controversy with all the trash can stuff. I still think he's really, really good. Looking at the stats that I compiled, I think 16 is more than fair to Alex Bregman. At 15, I have the new shortstop of the New York Mets, Francisco Lindor. And there's only one shortstop I put above him, which could be arguably, you know, above him, below him, whatever. I put Trevor Story in at 14, shortstop for the Colorado Rockies. I think he's just slightly above Francisco Lindor the last couple years. And number 13, I see this guy not getting much love. I know he's a little older, but he's still only 32, I believe. Clayton Kershaw, arguably the best pitcher of his generation. Still been a stud lately. I think he will have another good year, and I think he's got a couple left in it. Number 12, the new third baseman for the St. Louis Cardinals, Nolan Arenado. Doesn't crack the top 10, probably will next year after the season. He's just been so consistent and great, and I don't believe in the Coors effect as much as some other people do. Number 11, a guy who could be in the top 10 very shortly, Christian Yelich. I think he will have a bounce back year. Number 10, the second best pitcher in baseball, in my opinion, Garrett Cole, starting pitcher for the New York Yankees. At number 9, we have Cody Bellinger, outfielder slash first baseman for the Los Angeles Dodgers. I think he will also have a bounce back year. Him, Belly, and Yelly, I think they'll both have bounce back years. Number 8, we have third baseman for the Los Angeles Angels, Anthony Rendon. I think he's one of the most undervalued people in baseball, underrated, whatever you want to say. Glove, very nice. Bat, very nice. Contact, all sides of the field. Power, gets walks, doesn't strike out. He just does it all. Number 7, one of the youngest guys in baseball, outfielder for the Atlanta Braves, Ronald Acuna. Above him, we have another Brave at 6, first baseman, NL MVP, Freddie Freeman. At number 5, we have the new $340 million man, shortstop for the San Diego Padres, Fernando Tatis Jr. At number 4, we have the best pitcher in baseball, in my humble opinion, Jacob deGrom of the New York Mets. And then getting into our top 3. At number 3, this guy, I think, is probably, in my opinion, the second best hitter, maybe even arguably getting close up there with number 1, Juan Soto. I know some people have discrepancies against his fielding or that he hasn't been around long enough, but when it comes to Tatis and Acuna, he's played more games, he's been more consistent, he does everything on with the bat, you know, clutch, power, contact, walks, everything. And so I just think he's super underrated, and he's still so young, and he's getting better. There's no dips. He's just continually trending upward. Number 2, I think the second best overall player in baseball, we have Mookie Betts of the Los Angeles Dodgers. He came in, played right field for them, lockdown defender. He's got a cannon. He steals bags. Didn't have a great year at the bat last year, especially in the playoffs, but still a very good hitter. Can do it all, contact, power, as I've said. And the only guy that I think could be above those two is my best player in baseball, number 1 center fielder for the Los Angeles Angels, Michael Trout. What else do I have to say? It's Mike Trout. If you don't believe me, go look at the stats. If you still don't believe me, then you're wrong. Just kidding. But that's my top 50 guys for MLB players currently playing this next season. I think this was a decent top 50 list. I had some more discrepancies once it got to like 30 to 50. I could have went a lot of different ways. So let me know what you guys think. Like I said, I want to see comments. Don't feel bad. Don't feel whatever. Put it down there. Let me know what you guys think. And as always, please like, subscribe, turn on notifications, and come back for more MLB content very shortly. I'll see you guys later. Peace.